I'd have to go with Asseror. I love you, Arash. Actually, I want Arash to win, because I want Asseror out of the tournament. Get him out of here. The water flow down. Okay, Arash has built 3 slingers. 2 axe warriors, 3 axe warriors, Celt warrior. Illyrian marine, interesting. Noble hoplites, 4 of them, 5th with the general. So 3 total marines, 2 of the Illyrian cavalry, 3 Tarantine. Asseror, 3 Tarantine as well. That's the maximum amount that you can bring. 4 slingers. 2 marines for Asseror, Celt, 2 Celt warriors. It's like 3 noble hoplite, 4th with the general, 5th on the side, 2 cavalry, and a mercenary axe warrior. I'm gonna hold my breath for an hour. Oh, I just hiccuped up again.
Advance at speed! Forward! Riders at the double! I will kill any man who is at speed! Riders at the double! Advance at speed! Riders, advance!
Well, the Emperor's defeat the hiccups. It's a sweet... I could have kept holding my breath. That was, what, 2 minutes? Easy? I could have kept holding my breath. A sweet, sweet, sweet victory, yeah. Hiccups are no... I know all the strategies to eliminate a hiccup. That was only 37 seconds. Are you shitting me? You're lying. It was 2 minutes. I'm gonna pull up a timer. I'll do it again. 37 seconds. If it truly was 37 seconds, that is actually a shame. Emperor's voice wanes. A little bit of an exchange of fire. Arash, frustrated last battle by the big bad Emperor. What can I say? Waffle, how does it feel to be 1 win away from the semifinals? 1 win away. All I know is Barca's, he's already eliminated his tough opponents. Actually, they still got Lisu. Still gotta beat Lisu. Is 37 seconds, is that how long that Sean lasts with women? Ooh. Waffle says, I don't feel like I even won. He played Bactria and I spammed melee as Bowie Eye. And it worked. Holy crap. Well, good for you. 37 hours. Sean has no stimulus. There's no stimulus on his sword. There is none. Noble hoplites. Against those Tarantine, gonna take a nice volley and a volley from those Zax warriors. Sean has no enjoyment from Zax. Good God Almighty! Talk about Sean's libido. Is that the word for the sex drive? I don't know. This is basically a CB after dark. Is this noble hoplite not in the best formation? There's a little bit. It could get wrapped around easy. Yeah, Arash. I think Arash says he's in Iran or Iraq. So he's playing off of like a God knows what. I think he said he's playing off a hotspot. There you go. His mojo. Oh, nice turn from Arash. Right into the noble hoplites. Lead. Some support from Asseror. A little bit of melee in. Both sides going at it. Tarantine. Gotta be a little bit careful there. He's got that melee cap very close. still his right flank and left flank of Asseror. The right flank of Arash, both of them not moving. It's all focused on one side. So Asseror likes to use his marines, but are these guys doing more damage than good? That is the question. They are firing away. See their kills. 5 kills. I would say they're doing more damage than good. Barca wins. Barca into the championship. Teamed. As this is the loser's bracket round number one, Arash and Asseror crushed him. Orders understood. Oh, nice release in the pillum. Very good. I think we're gonna finally get this other flank involved. The Living Noble Hoplites into the back of the Kilt Warriors. Kilt Warriors already lost a lot of men. They're down to 34 men, so they took a big hit. The mirror battles have been all the action, all the girth today. I don't think that there's... Oh, it sounds like Waffle didn't do a mirror. There's still lots of units in reserves. The Slingers firing upon. Asseror not even worried about this flank. Not even worried. Arash, you know, maybe he shifts this way and sends his units in. And they're kind of far away. But then I guess Asseror just gets a nice easy flank. Still we go. Balance of power leaning in favor of Asseror. Asseror is your red banner. Arash is your yellow banner. Very good. Tarantine 21 and 26. Arash still has his Tarantine. Both saw the Tarantine, both still have the melee cav. Well, this melee cav though, very low. 15 men. Asseror's paying attention. Could have gone to the Tarantine. Wants to go to the Celts Warriors. Now he gets into the Tarantine. Trying to make up his mind. Not an easy decision. Looks like there's some nice slinger shots. Finding the idle cav, always a good thing to do. Noble Hoplites on the outer edge. Oh, okay, they're gone. Their battle rhythm is decreasing their firepower. But look at this. It's the 4 slinger focus against Arash's general. Against his general, just letting loose the firepower. I need to get a Tarantine to get in there. This general. Yes, they'll take some damage, but still, I think every slinger is focused there. Seeing every man fire upon, and the backs are exposed. Marine versus Marine. So here's what Asseror does, and all the, you know, top tier players, they do a very good job keeping their slingers protected. So the protection is available. Look at that too. Illyrian Hoplite, didn't even know he had an Illyrian Hoplite. Being aided by the Axe Warriors, the Hoplite backing off. Trying to pursue those Marines. Looks like Asseror's still offering some nuisances over here. This Kelt Warrior has been alive for quite a while, still alive. The central is opening up. With that means that the angles to the slingers for both have opened. Or might finally wrap up that Kelt Warrior. 61 of those Noble Hoplites. Still got the general untouched. I'd say Rash's general, 53. 53 as he's still getting pelted. Still getting pelted, no answer. As this full Illyrian Marine has just walked into the back line, slingers routing. Hoplite could not get to them in time and has to sacrifice some lives of the Tarantine cavalry. So Tarantine being a sacrificial lamb. Dean. Sean. Well, Ultron was probably upset because he got melee spammed by Waffle. So he wants to go hard. Sean is gonna find himself as an early exit, maybe, at this rate, with his comments. Shame. Still has the Marines of Asseror. Bounce of power, leaning Asseror. Arash's general decimated the 4 slingers. Let's check the kills. 49, 63, 56, and 33. It's now. There we go. Eid. Nice strike. Good strike. We're playing bowling, I guess. Still 2v1 calf situation.
Charge! What
if Arash has anything within his underbelly. Still those slave slingers. Binding, firing, hitting, killing, pillaging. The general using second wind, but he is outnumbered and outslung. He should be killed. What's left? Arash is all his cav. Asseror is all his cav. And finding the slingers. He is deep within the enemy lines as this one is all but finished. The clean performance by our three-time Total War League champion. He says, I'm not done yet. Give me my next unfortunate soul. As it is Beamista. Sarah moves on. It's now. Go ahead and take a peek at the old bracket, huh? I was told Barca with a thick performance. Getting in there, Donald Duck facing Waffle. Massive. Here we go. GG's, Sarah. GG to Arash.